A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
As you all know, this will be a practice class where you revise all that you have learned in this module. You will also learn some new things. Let us begin by revising what you learned in the last class. Can you tell why the exact formula is used? With the exact formula, you can find out whether the selected text are exactly the same or not. If you have given an extra space in one of them, then this formula will show you the result as false. Do you know which formula you will use if you want to get the first three characters from any text? If you want to get the first three characters from some text, then you will use the left formula for doing so. Do you know why we use the mid formula? Using the mid formula, you can get the desired number of characters from any text from the middle of the text till the place selected by you. Do you know why the find formula is used? With the find, you can find any text or symbol from your data or text. Do you know why the split option is used? With the split option, you can divide or split your active sheet into parts. Power on your computers now and open the spreadsheet file. Let us now see what you will learn today and what you will revise. You will first make a table and then you will learn about the HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP formulas. After that, you will learn about the formulas for sum, if, min or minimum, max or maximum, today, and find. Lastly, you will revise conditional formatting and filter options. Now, make the table being shown to you. Let's now learn about VLOOKUP. You will use VLOOKUP when you need to find information about a complete column from a sheet. For example, if Ravi is written in a certain column and you want the entire information of this column, then you will apply the VLOOKUP formula. Let us now use the video to learn about use of VLOOKUP formula. By watching this video, let us now understand how we use the VLOOKUP formula. VLOOKUP formula will help you to get any data from any column on your sheet. So since we want to do it on sheet 2, we are just copying the first column from sheet 1 and copying it to sheet 2. So that we can apply the VLOOKUP on sheet 2. So we have just copied and pasted the A column from sheet 1. And in column B, in the first cell, in the first row of column B, we are applying the VLOOKUP formula. So we have to type equal to VLOOKUP, VLOOKUP, begin bracket, and then we have to give a search criteria. So we have criteria, we have selected name as the search criteria. Next we have to give the array. So from sheet 1, we select the text from where we want the information to be taken out. So we are selecting this entire text or the entire data that we have on sheet 1. As you can see, we have selected this. And you can see in the formula bar, we are applying the VLOOKUP, and you can see it here also. So next you need to give the index on the basis of which, or you have to select the column essentially from where you want the information to come. So you can see there is sales 1, there's sales 2, sales 3. So different columns are there. So we are selecting the sales 1 column as is being shown in the video to you. So next it says sort order. So we put a semicolon and then the sort order, in this case we are not changing the sort order, so we just type 0, close the bracket, and now we can see in sheet 2 that we have got our sales 1, the title of the second column has come here using VLOOKUP. If we select this cell and then drag downwards, automatically all the values for sales 1 will be shown on our sheet 2. So you can see all the values are shown. If you drag this down further, you will see NA is written. So this is because there is no value available here. Now if on sheet 1 in the names column we had two more names, H and I, and there are some values for sales 1 for these two also, H and I, then if we look at sheet 2, just copy paste the H and I columns on of column A on sheet 2 and you will see that the values for sales 1 for the new entries H and I are also shown on our sheet 2. So this way you can use VLOOKUP for getting information from any column on your sheet. Let's now learn about the HLOOKUP. HLOOKUP is also used just like VLOOKUP, but the difference is that instead of columns, you will get data about rows with HLOOKUP. Let us learn more about HLOOKUP with this video. Let us now see the usage of the HLOOKUP formula. With the HLOOKUP formula, we can get all the information for any row of our Calc sheet. So in order to apply the HLOOKUP formula, we will do that on the third sheet, which is blank right now. So first from sheet 1, we have selected the title row or the first row, and we've copied it so that we can paste it on sheet number 3. So we are doing that as is being shown to you in the video. Now we need to apply the HLOOKUP formula. So we select the cell just below the name and apply the formula here, or type in the formula, which will be equal to then HLOOKUP begin bracket. Then you have to select the search criteria or select the column which you want to find the information for. So we have selected name. Then we have to select the array or the entire table. So we select sheet 1 and we select the entire table from where we are looking for the information on the row. So we have selected, as you can see, the entire table or the entire data on the sheet 1. Then we have to put a semicolon, which we are also seeing this in the sheet 3. We put a semicolon, then we have to define the index or which row we want to get the information for. So once again, go back to sheet 1 and we want the information for the third row or the row where B name is written. So we select that 3, which is the third row, and then we have to define the sort order. Since we don't want to sort it, we will just put 0 there and then close the bracket and press enter. Once you press enter, you can see on the third sheet in the column where, in the cell where you had applied this formula, the B row B name has appeared. Now if we drag it towards the right side, you will see all the information for the B row is available to us on sheet 3. So this way you can apply HLOOKUP for getting information for any row on your Calc sheet. Let us now revise some of the formulas. Go ahead and show how you will do the sum. If you have any doubts, learn by watching the video. In this video, we will just be revising the sum formula, which already all of you know. So, as you know, we have the total column where we will find the sum of all the sales for sales 1, sales 2, sales 3. So, we first apply the formula there, just below where total title is written. So, we type equal to, and for sum, it is SUM, the formula, begin bracket, and then select all the numbers that you want to add or find the sum of. Then close the bracket and press enter. So, you get the total of all the sales 1, sales 2, sales 3 for A row or A. Similarly, if you want for all the others, now you can just select the same cell where you applied the formula and drag downwards, and you will get all the answers for all the rows. You will get the total sales here. This is how you can use sum. Next, show how you will apply the if formula. If while applying the formula, you face a problem, watch the video. Let us now practice the use of the if formula. As you know, if formula uses some condition to define. So, we are going to look at the target. So, we are going to see if A, B, C and all of these rows, if they have met a certain target or not. So, just below where target is written, we are going to apply the formula equal to if, then begin the bracket, select the number that we want to check. We have selected the total value and we are saying if the total sales is greater than 195, then we put a semicolon and then we put the conditional statement. If this is true, then within inverted commas, we are saying the answer should be completed. So, we have typed completed and closed the inverted commas, put a semicolon, and if it is not true, then we wanted to say not complete. So, we put not complete in inverted commas, close the bracket, and then press enter. So, what it means is, if the sales value, total sales value is greater than 195, it will say completed. So, you can see as soon as we press enter, for A row, it is saying completed because 222 is greater than 195. Now, if we want to apply the same formula for all the rows, we just put our pointer on the black dot, and when it appears as a plus sign, we just drag it down, and you can see wherever the value of total sales is greater than 195, it is saying completed. If the value is not 195, it is saying not complete. So, this way you can use the if formula and apply a condition. Now, using the max formula, find out the maximum value for any one column. Again, if you face a problem, watch the video. Let us now practice the use of the maximum formula to find the maximum value of one of these rows in our sheet. So let's write in G1 cell the title maximum, M-A-X-I-M-U-M. And in the next cell below that, let's type the formula, which is M equal to M-A-X. Begin the bracket with shift and 9 and then select the numbers. Close the bracket and press enter. You see that the maximum value, which is 81, is shown here. So this is how you can practice the use of the maximum formula on your sheet. Now, all of you show how you will get the date in any one cell of your sheet. If in doubt, watch the video. Let us watch this video and learn the usage of the today formula. With today formula, you can get in any cell on your sheet today's date. So today gives you the date, today's date from your computer. So firstly, let's type the title today, because this is where we are trying to apply that formula for today. In the next cell, let's type the formula for today, which is equal to T-O-D-A-Y, today. And then begin bracket with shift and 9 and close bracket with shift and 0. Remember, you don't have to type any numbers, anything within the brackets. Just press enter and you can see that you get today's date in that cell where you wanted, where you applied the today's formula. So this way you can use today formula. Show how you will obtain the minimum value from any one row, and if you have problems, learn by watching the video. Let us now practice the use of the minimum formula. Minimum will get you the minimum value from the cells that you select. So to apply minimum, first let's type the title minimum, M-I-N-I-M-U-M. And then in the cell below, let's apply the formula, which is equal to, and then for minimum, you need to type only M-I-N, begin the bracket with shift and 9, and then you need to select the cells from where you want to find the minimum. So we have selected cells 1, cells 2, cells 3 of first row, A row. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you can see that the minimum value, the minimum sales, which is sales 2 in this case, 66, is shown here. So this way you can apply minimum to get the minimum value. Next, all of you show the use of the AND formula. Remember to have one answer as true and one as false. If you face a problem, watch the video. Let us now practice the use of the AND formula. In the AND formula, there are two values or two conditions given, and if both are true, then the answer will be true. Otherwise, even if one of them is false, the answer will be false. So let's write AND in the I column as the title. Then in the next cell, let's apply the formula for AND, which is equal to AND, begin bracket with shift and 9, and then select the logical value 1. So let's select the total in A row, which is 222. And we apply a condition that this total should be greater than 200. So you can see 222 is greater than 200. So this statement is true. Then we put a semicolon and apply the next condition. So we have now selected the value 252. And we have applied the condition that this value should be greater than 250. This statement also is true. So when you put the close, when you close the bracket and press enter, you will see that the answer that you get where you have applied the formula, it is true, as is being shown in the video to you. So this way you can use AND formula. Now let's see what happens if one of the statements is true but the other statement is false. So let's apply the AND formula in the next cell, equal to AND, begin bracket. Again we choose 222 as our first logical value from the total column and apply the condition. Let's apply the same condition. This value is greater than 200. So as you know, 222 is greater than 200. So this statement is true. Then we put a semicolon and select the next logical value. Again, let's select 252. But this time we are applying a condition that this value is less than 250. Now you know that 252 is not less than 250. So this statement is false. So when you close the bracket and press enter, the answer is false. So in an AND statement, one of the statements was true, but the other statement was false. So the answer will be false. So this is how you can use the AND formula on your sheet. Now apply conditional formatting on the table. If you face a problem in applying conditional formatting, then take help, learn by watching the video. Watching this video, let us practice the use of conditional formatting. With conditional formatting, you can choose conditions and then apply a format or a formatting on the cells that meet that condition. So let's first select the data on our sheet. So we are selecting the whole data, all the data on our sheet to apply the conditional formatting. Take the pointer to the format menu in the menu bar and left click on that. And from the box that opens, click on the conditional formatting option. So as soon as you click on the conditional formatting option, a box opens. And it has, as you can see, three conditions you can apply. So for the first condition, the cell value is, so we are applying a condition to the cell value and we can choose one of the conditions. So we are saying if the cell value is greater than, and then we have to give a condition. So we have typed a number here, 85. And then we are saying if this happens, then change the cell style, and from if we click on this drop down box, we can select untitled 1. So it will change wherever the cell value is greater than 85, it will apply this cell style of untitled 1 on that cell. Let's apply the second condition, tick on the second condition, and this option becomes available. This time we are saying if the cell value is less than 85, and this time we are choosing the cell style as the untitled 2 option. So if the cell value is less than 85, then the cell style will become untitled 2. Now the third condition we are applying is if the cell value is equal to 85. If it is equal, then we are saying let the cell style be default style. Now we will just click OK and you will see the changes happening on your table. So wherever the cell value was greater than 85, you can see the untitled 1 condition cell style has been applied, which is the reddish color. Wherever the cell value was less than 85, all four sides border has been applied on that cell, because that is what the untitled 2 style was. And wherever the cell value is equal to 85, the cell style has been left as default, as it was. There is no change. So this way you can apply the conditional formatting on your table. Next, apply filter on any one column. If you have a problem in doing this, learn by watching the video. Let us now practice the use of applying filters on our table. So, to apply the filter, with the filter, we can see any information on any column or row that we apply the filter on. So, first, let's select the first row to apply the filter. So, we have selected the first cell here, A1. Then we take a pointer to data, left click on that, and then bring a pointer to filter and click on auto filter option. So as soon as you click on auto filter option, you can see that drop down boxes have come on each of the first row cells. So you can see if you click on the drop down box, you can click on one of the options which is visible there. For instance, it is showing the information of A right now. You can select all, you can select any of them. Now, since we clicked on name, it is showing the name row and all the information there. So, you can click on all to see all the information. So, this way, you can apply filters and use it to see options. Information of one by one rows or columns. Now convert your file into PDF format and then save your file. And then close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you revise some formulas like sum, if, max, min, today and find. And also revised conditional formatting and filter options. And you also learned about HLOOKUP and VLOOKUP.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.